I am so tired. So I was just watching your Disneyland video, and when you were on Indiana Jones, it made me think of all my Indiana Jones experience. That is one of my family's favorite rides at Disneyland, and I used to be terrified of it because I thought everything was real. And it didn't help that my brother and sister would play off of this, and I don't know if they realized how gullible I was. They probably did, because older siblings always take advantage of their younger siblings. But yeah, they pretty much just fed the fear, and so I thought for sure every time I was going on this ride, I was risking my life. I was going to die. And when we finally get into the car and they start going, I thought that one of these times the snake was going to get the person that was on the outer edge, so I never wanted to sit on the outer edge. I thought that the bridge would collapse and I'd fall into the flame and burn to a crisp. And that one room you go through and you kind of see like skeletons on the wall and they blow darts at you. I thought they were really blowing darts, and that it was just going right past my head, and I almost died every time. Well, it's you. You are ruining my video. I always had to sit by my parents, one of my parents on that ride, because, you know, if you sit by your parents, there's no way you can die. But there was this one time that I didn't sit by my parents. I sat by my aunt. And I remember telling her when we sat down that basically that I usually have to sit by my parents for safety. And I was just like, but I guess you work too. You'll be okay. I don't think she knew how to respond to that. Another thing that went through my mind is not this last time I went to Disneyland, but the time before. The Indiana Jones ride broke down while we were on it, which kind of seems like a bummer, I guess. But at least it's not like the Haunted Mansion when you get stuck next to something like the Singing Heads or something, and it just keeps going over and over and over. That's happened to me too. But, on Indiana Jones, they actually had to evacuate the ride. And so they, everything was stopped, and the lights came on, and that ride looks completely different when it's not in the dark. Little details I had no idea were there, I now knew were there. For example, that little snake area corner, there's like little rubber snakes like nailed to the walls everywhere. I never even noticed. The only snake you see is the giant one that almost eats you. It was pretty awesome to walk through Indiana Jones. You missed out. What? The Rivers of America or whatever it was open when you were there? Okay, I was only there like a month ago. I guess it's been a little over a month now. And it was totally closed. And the water wasn't even in there. All the water was gone. And they had this big old fence around it. I'm jealous. But usually when we go, it seems like that the ride that's closed down is It's a Small World, which we usually don't have a problem with. And this last time when we went, it was open and I hadn't been on it for years, and so it's like, the only part I really remember is the song, and I know there's like little dolls in there singing it. It's a small world after all. Would you believe that we went on that ride a total of 4 times when we were there?
Now we are heading into the room of white supremacy.
In case you didn't know by now, I'm kind of a dork and know tons of useless information. There was this one time. Have you ever heard of the site Snopes.com? I used to go on there all the time, and it talks about all these myths and legends and rumors, and whether or not they're true or false. Disney has its own section on this site, so I went on there and read every single rumor that they had on Disney, and whether or not they were true. And in the Disneyland portion, one of the rumors is that the hearse outside of the Haunted Mansion was the same hearse used when Brigham Young died. Well, I'm sorry to break it to you, but that's actually false. So, just commenting on your Utah footage, you said that you thought it would be a pretty place to record. And it just made me think, I never really thought of Utah as that pretty. I guess because it's not green and I'm used to green. But it wasn't until I came back from the British Literary Tour that I realized that it's a different sort of beauty, that wherever you go, you can find beauty around you if you are willing to see it and accept it as its own kind of beauty. I think part of what helped me realize this was the first thing I saw when I got back from Europe was Utah. We landed in the Salt Lake Airport, and as we're driving through Utah, I was just so happy to be back in my own country. Not that I didn't love Europe, because I absolutely loved it. There are so many great places to go and see and things to experience, but after a while, you kind of have this longing for home. When we got back home and I was looking out at Utah and just this sense of being home overwhelmed me, I realized that even what I had considered to be the barren wastelands of Utah are beautiful. So yes, it is beautiful. Side note, I think your videos were starting to give me motion sickness. Another thing, can I just say that I am tickled pink by the fact that you could not guess the soundtrack? Tickled! I thought that you were going to get it right away, and it would be something so easy, whatever, but you couldn't guess it! So it makes it a lot more fun and entertaining for me. So, we'll give you a new clue today. It is from a Disney film. We'll just give you another sound clip, and if you can't get it, then I'll give you another clue. Ready? 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 Go!